I, Assistant Professor Santosh Shelke, welcome you all on behalf of MS Kakadi College, Someshwar Nagar. Similarly, I welcome Honorable Mr. Vinay K.Y. and Honorable Dr. Arvind Nawle sir as the resource persons of this one-day webinar. I am also grateful to the convener of this seminar and the principal of our college, Professor Jawahar Chaudhary sir, for his graceful online presence. I also acknowledge, welcome, and honor the presence of Honorable Satish Rao Kakde Deshmukh, the President, Honorable Professor Devant Rao Ghorpade, the Secretary, and Honorable Satish Lakde, the Joint Secretary of our college. In the same way, I welcome all the participants, my colleagues, and friends who have joined this webinar online. Now, after these brief welcoming remarks, I once again repeat that the theme of the webinar is Revised NAAC Accreditation System. In order to illustrate the purpose of selecting this theme, may I now request Dr. Sanju Jadhav, the coordinator of the webinar, to give a short introduction to the topic of the webinar. Dr. Sanju Jadhav.
Good morning. On the occasion of the One Day National Webinar on Revised NAAC Accreditation System organized by the Internal Quality Assurance Cell of MS Kakadi College, Someshwar Nagar, as a coordinator of IQC, I, Dr. Sanju Jadhav, warmly welcome the today's resource person of the first session, Honorable Vinay Kenkare sir, the Assistant Nodal Officer, State Quality Assurance Cell, Department of Collegiate and Technical Education, Government of Karnataka. I also welcome the second resource person of the second session, Honorable Dr. Arvind Nawle sir, who is the Head Department of English, Shivaji Mahavidyalaya Udgir, who is the former NAAC coordinator of the college and currently is the member of BOS in English, Nanded University, Nanded. Actually, he's an innovative international academician. I also welcome the Honorable Satish Bhaiya Kakde Deshmukh, who is the chairman of my institute. I also welcome the Honorable Secretary of my institute, Jayvant Ghorpade sir. Sri Satish Lakde sir, who is the Joint Secretary of my institute. Principal of my college, respected Jawahar Chaudhary sir. Vice Principal, Dr. Jaya Kadam madam. And all the principals, IQC coordinators, members from the various colleges who have already joined for this webinar. All the IQC members of my college, Dr. D.B. Vaidande sir, P.T. Jadhav sir, Selke sir, Gadge sir, More sir, Rajurwar sir, Gaikwad sir. Especially, I also welcome Professor Abhimanyu Mane sir from Karmala, the principal of Big One College, Dr. Walun sir, Gadekar sir, Nagne sir, and all the academicians who are participated in this webinar. Once again, I welcome you all. So before moving to the introduction of this webinar, I must give the brief information of my institute. Our institute is established in June 1972 by the late visionary founder of the institute, Mugutha Sahib Rao Kakde Deshmukh, to provide the facility of the higher education to the rural students, particularly from the weaker sections of a society. Our institute is a multi-faculty institute where the art, commerce, science, and BBA, CA faculties are in exist. Along with all these faculties, we have the four UG programs, BA, BCom, BAE, and BBA, two PG programs like MA, MCom, and along with all these programs, actually, the UGC has recently sanctioned the 6 advanced diploma courses and 8 occasional courses from the state government of Maharashtra. In my institute, there are NSS and NCC units. Our campus is well designed with the physical facilities like the central library, digital language laboratory, computer labs, smart classrooms, credit cooperative society, student store, well spacious auditorium, and the public library. Our college has some welfare schemes for the students, just like the earn and learn scheme, students welfare schemes, poor boys fund, student insurance policy, special guidance schemes. Actually, I'm proud to say you that our campus is the eco-friendly, the green campus. And that's why actually we are the recipient of the one award from the government for the green campus, because in our campus, we have well established the rainwater harvesting system that is well known in the Maharashtra state. We observe the no vehicle day once in a week on every Saturday. Our campus is the plastic free campus. We have the composting plant in our campus. We have the botanical garden and landscapings. We are also recipient of the two awards for the extension and community oriented activities. Generally, we conduct the nearby areas. We have generated the fund more than the 4 crore rupees in the last 3 years, and our institute is accredited 3 times, and we are currently bearing the B++ means 2.80 score for our institute, and now appear for the 4th cycle. Our IQC has developed the more than 10 MOUs and the collaborations with the well organizations nearby the college. We have also the awards, several awards for the faculty members, the Best Teacher Award, Best Award for Non-Teaching Staff, Best Award for the annual magazine, that is a Mukut, and the Best Research Award for some faculties. So in this way, in the last 2 years, we have organized the 5 seminars in our college, 2 were the state level and the 3 were the national level. 1 syllabus restructuring workshop was also conducted in our college by the Department of History. In the last year, in February 19, 2019, we had organized the national seminar on NAC, revised accreditation system. So in similar way, so now a lot we know that in the COVID-19 pandemic situation, actually everywhere in a country, there are the various institutes that are organizing the webinars on the various topics of a NAC. But now we know that the NAC has brought the new spirit in the assessment and accreditation process in the revised process, in the revised manual from the February 2020, because the system now is more robust, objective, transparent, scalable, and the technology ICT enabled. So in this revised system, Alaf, we know that actually there are the very innovative and new recent systems, just like the system generated score, SGS, third-party data validation, qualitative and quantitative metrics, student satisfaction survey, and offsite the evaluation process. So all these are the innovations. And that's why I think just there is need of the truly understanding of all these concepts of revised system. So we know that the NAC evaluates the institute on the its performance, particularly related to the evaluation process and the outcomes, curriculum, feedback system, teaching learning process, research and innovation, infrastructure, learning resources, student support and progression, governance, financial well-being, institutional best practices, and social responsibilities. So that's why actually each and every institute must have to change and to change its approach toward the all the stakeholders of the institute. And I think the role of the IQC definitely should have to change, because it is considered as the prototype in quality assessment and the enhancement at the institutional level. So we considering all these points, actually we have organized this national webinar on the revised accreditation system of a NAC. So everywhere we know that the various organizations organize the such type of webinars on the general topics of the accreditation system. Just like the documentation, data preparation, submission of a report, various audits, pre, during, and post peer team visit preparation. But we know that actually there are 2 areas. For example, the qualitative metrics. We know that for the quantitative metrics, we have given the standard operating process, that is the SOP. And all the institutes take such type of the support of the SOP and can manage or maintain all the documentations. But very rarely we find that the webinar is organized on the qualitative metrics. And that's why, due to the demand of all the members of my IQC, actually we have selected this topic for this today's webinar. So in this way, student satisfaction survey, we know that actually there is too much confusion on a student satisfaction survey there, because due to the absence of a student, actually institute cannot conduct this student satisfaction survey. And actually they cannot complete their score required percentage. And that's why actually the peer team visit can be postponed there. And that's why we have taken this to neglected areas for today's webinar. So I'm sure and hope that the keen deliberations and discussions will happen in this webinar, and it will enable all the participants to identify their strengths, their weaknesses, and opportunities to fulfill. So in this way, I'm sure that this webinar will provide the very good exposure to all the participants to interact with today's very eminent and renowned resource person, just like the Honorable Kenkare sir and Dr. Arvind Nawale sir. Today we have for the two sessions. So with this brief introduction, I conclude my here the short introduction of this webinar and about the brief history of my institute. So thank you once again. I welcome you all for this webinar. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. After this short introduction to the webinar, may I now request the principal of our college, Professor Jawahar Chaudhary sir, to express his views on the webinar.
Good morning to all of you. First of all, I welcome all the participants, the Honorable Chairman of our college, Satish Rao Kakde Deshmukh, Honorable Secretary of our college, Professor Jayant Rao Gurpade, Honorable Satish Lakde, and IQC Coordinator, Dr. Sanjeev Jadhav. On the occasion of one day national webinar on the topic, Revised NAC Accreditation System, organized by Internal Quality Assurance Cell, IQC, of our college. In this webinar, we have invited two eminent resource persons to deliver the session. One resource person, Mr. Vinay Kenkare, Assistant Nodal Officer, State Quality Assurance Cell, Government of Karnataka, who has detailed knowledge about the NAC revised guidelines. His topic on qualitative metrics and its documentation. Second resource person, Dr. Arvind Nawale, Head Department of English, Shivaji Mahavidyalaya Udyapeeth, who is also member of Board of Studies in English, Sri Ramananda Tirth, Marathwada University, Nanded. His topic on student satisfaction survey. His more than 15 books are published on national, international level. Thus, these two resource persons who delivered their lecture on NAC revised system in their two sessions. I am sure and hope that their session will facilitate all the participants towards innovative insight about the NAC process. I wish best wishes for this webinar and hope detailed discussion on this topic. Thank you.
Ole sir, as the resource person, and he will address on the topic student satisfaction survey. However, before beginning the session, I will request my colleague, Dr. Shrikant Ghadge sir, to briefly introduce this session's resource person, Honorable Dr. Arvind Nawale sir.
Good Good afternoon, everybody. Respected all dignitaries, faculty members, research scholar, and all participants. I am Assistant Professor Dr. Srikant Tukaram Ghadge, Department of Geography, and in charge of second criteria, that is teaching, learning, and evolution. Today, Internal Quality Assurance Cell, IQAC, of our MS Kakde College, Someshwar Nagar, Taluka Baramati, District Pune, organized national webinar on reverse NAC accreditation system. In second session of this webinar, it's my pleasure to introduce and welcome the resource person, Honorable Dr. Arvind Manikrao Navle sir, Head Department of English, Shivaji Mahavidyalay, Udgir, District Latur, Maharashtra. Sir is MA, BEd and PhD in English. He has more than 23 years of teaching experience at senior college level. His administrative experience is very impressive. Sir has completed rigorous military training at Officer Training Academy Kamti and work as NCC Commission Officer, Company Commander more than 10 years, and his last rank was Captain. He was also work as NSS Program Officer. He was former coordinator of NAC Steering Committee and IQAC. He is a member of various committees at university and national level. He work as member of Board of Studies in English, SRTM University, Nanded, member of Senate, SRTM University, Nanded, member of Faculty of Arts in SRTM University, Nanded, chairman of various committees, external examiner at PhD coursework, and Youth Festival, Solapur University, Solapur, external referee of PhD, MPhil dissertation of different university, member of editorial, advisory, review board of 15 prestigious journals. He has published more than 45 books. Out of 45 books, near about 30 books are subscribed by the world, and more than 150 renowned overseas libraries, including USA, UK, South Africa, Australia, Germany. He has published more than 46 research papers in referred UGC listed journals with ISN ISBN number. His Google Scholar citation is 42, H index is 03, and I10 index is 2. He has presented more than 24 research national and international conferences. He has been delivered 47 guest lectures at various part of country. He is a renowned research guide. 9 student completed PhD and 5 student doing their PhD under the guidance of Dr. Navle sir. He has completed 1 UGC sponsored minor research project in English. Sir has lot of experience in the field of education. In this session, Honorable Dr. Navle sir will guide us on topic student satisfaction survey, that is SSSS. This survey is very complicated. NAC peer team cannot visit to college before completion of this survey. Many teachers have various questions on their mind about this survey. I hope that through this lecture, sir will surely solve all the questions, and this session will be fruitful for all of us. I again welcome to Dr. Navle sir, and may I request them to deliver lecture on student satisfaction survey. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Professor. The Management Secretary, Honorable Jaivant Rao Ji Ghorpade, Saab. Principal, Dr. Jawar Chaudhary Ji. The IQAC coordinator and convener of this one-day national webinar on revised like accreditation system, and a good friend of mine, Dr. Sanju Jadhav, Dr. Vaidande, Dr. Rajurkar, and other members of iChristian organizing team of the MS Kakadi College, Someshwar Nagar, Pune. My co-panelist, Assistant Nodal Officer, State Quality Assurance Cell, Department of Technical Education, Government of Karnataka, Honorable Dr. K.Y. Vinayji, and esteemed participants. A very good afternoon to one and all. In first session, admin, please allow me to share my screen. You are requested to make me host, yes, sir. Yes, sir. So that yes, I would be able to share my screen. Okay. In the first session, Dr. K.Y. Vinayji talked very elaborately, wonderfully on quantitative metrics and its documentation, and covered all 7 criterions. And now it is my turn. And the topic assigned to me for this plenary session is the Student Satisfaction Survey, which is popularly known with its acronyms as SSS. That is SSS. And I am supposed to cover the procedure of conducting SSS, which forms component 2.7, one of very complicated, as stated by the anchor now, while introducing me. Not only complicated, but also well said, yet very important part, not only of criterion 2, but also of NAC's whole assessment and accreditation process. Friends, though our entire education system focuses on its most important stakeholder, that is the student, until then, there had been no provision or appropriate and systematic framework for the assessment of teachers and the overall functioning of the educational institutions, its services, its teaching, and quality of education by students. In India, there are about 833 universities plus 42,000 colleges and 35.7 million students. So there is a need to get real feedback from the students' community to enhance the quality of higher education. Student satisfaction should be an integral component of management process in addition to academic standards, accreditation, teaching, and research. SSS tells us about the opinion of students about the efficiency of various facilities like library, laboratory, academics, teaching materials, hostel, internet, drinking water, cleanliness, and hygiene, infrastructure, sports and games, extracurricular activities, and other student-related facilities available in the campus. And also about the requirements for difficult services. Therefore, such survey gives an outline about how things should be planned to ensure better services and facilities to students who are the foremost stakeholder of the college. Since its establishment in 1994, NAC has been actively working to advance our country's higher education. A major goal of education by colleges and universities has been considered to be sustaining and enhancing the satisfaction of students. In the revised assessment and accreditation framework introduced in July 2017, NAC introduced the Student Satisfaction Survey, known as SSS, which characterizes an evident paradigm shift in the HEIS assessment and accreditation process. The revised assessment and accreditation framework introduced many welcoming changes. The new AA process is streamlined, and the number of questions, the size of the report, and the days of the visit are decreased. By implementing the peer team visit pre-qualifier, by introducing the system created scores, that is SSS, with a mix of 70% online assessment and 30% peer judgment. By introducing third-party data validation, which is called as a DVV, of which we are very afraid of, by introducing suitable differences in metrics, weightages, and benchmarks to universities, autonomous and affiliated and constituted colleges, and above all, by introducing the more active participation of students in AA process through AAAS, the NAC made the AA process more robust, objective, transparent, outcome-oriented and stakeholder-friendly. Students' level of contentment, that is satisfaction, is determined by the kinds of experiences they encounter, the magnitude of the feeling of comfort and the intellectual stimulus generated by learning situations. Their inputs substantially reflect the actual quality of teaching learning process, enabling identifications of the strengths of teaching as well as the possible improvements therein. Enabling identifications of the some other things, some drawbacks. This is a direct indicator of the effectiveness of teaching learning process in the institution. This is the reason the revised assessment framework of NAC has introduced the survey of student satisfaction. AAAS is conducted on two levels. First, we have to take this note of it, that first SSS is a regular annual survey by IQC at institution level. And second, SSS is being conducted by NAC authorities as a part of a process before their on-ground visit. In AAAS, as a regular annual survey by IQC at institutional level, students are asked to assess their educational experiences in college. They are given a questionnaire which asks for their feedback on their overall classroom experience, co-curricular activities, and the campus. The questionnaires or the questionnaire forms are handed over to them in confidentially, in wherein they express their opinions freely. The responses of the students are then analyzed by the committee formed by the principal and the coordinator of IQC. Teachers and the rest concerns are informed about analysis made by the students and changes, if necessary, to be made therein. At NAC level, NAC authorities conduct AAAS as a part of a process before their on-site visit. The student satisfaction survey is an efficient feedback mechanism and is an attempt to promote the quality assurance process to involve students who are the primary stakeholders. The SSR for UG and PG affiliated or constituent colleges has a total of 93 and 96 metrics. With the help of the student satisfaction survey, your SSR will be validated. The AAAS is being carried out at the same level as the DVV, that is a data validation.
Excuse me, sir. Nowle, sir.
Yes, please.
You can you share your screen because...
Yeah, I was unable to share. That's why I'm talking. Oh. Let me see.
Yes, sir. Now we can see your PPT, sir.
You have to interrupt me before that also. Okay.
Yeah.
Is it visible now?
Yes, yes, sir.
Okay,
yes,
okay. Yes, please interrupt me. What is the technical problem in encountered?
Yes, continue.
Okay. I was saying that the questionnaires will be mailed to the student by NAC authorities, and response is less than 10% of the total students are not considered for evaluation. Questionnaire will be in English and probably it may be translated in a local language too. The students across different classes, year of enrollment, programs and gender will be covered. It will be conducted simultaneously with DVV process. need to upload data of all or at least 50% of current enrolled students as per data template format of Excel sheet given in on the portal. One for college, UGRPZ and autonomous. Responses should be received from at least 10% of the total students or 100, whichever is lesser, and for university, 10% of students population or 500, whichever is lesser. TSS will be completed within 2 weeks, which I have taken screenshot from the NAC website, its portal. What is expected, that is name of the student, gender, category, state of domicile, and nationality, then Indian if he is overseas student. Upload data of all currently enrolled students or at least 50% as per the data template format in Excel sheet. Data will be expected in text format only. The column names case sensitive and order should not be altered. No column cell should be left blank. Repetition of name, email address, mobile number is not allowed. There are 2 separate columns for student's ID and enrollment ID. In the absence of separate IDs, the institution can repeat same ID in the 2 columns. Total entries should not be greater than the students marked in institutional information for quality assessment, that is IIQA. TSS will be administered to institution which qualify for the peer team visit, that is after clearing the pre-qualified stage. Then next slide. How the analysis? The analysis of the objective questions. There are 20 objective questions, as I have already stated, and students will respond on a scale of 4 to 0, with the most positive responses rated as 4 and most negative as a 0. The mean course for each question will be calculated and the overall mean will be arrived at. This figure will range from 4 to 0 and will give the mean satisfaction level of the students for the particular institutes. Then analysis of the open-ended question. The students are asked to give 3 observations or suggestions to improve the overall teaching learning experience in the question number 24. First, and the analysis would be carried out by aggregating the most occurrent suggestions in the students' responses. This should provide an idea of the most general experience, expectations, observations, and suggestions from the students. This information can be provided to peer team conducting on-site visit to be used for the validation as well as peer team report presentation. Teachers' skills such as subject knowledge, communication skill, class preparation, and so on, evaluation and use of ICT tools are the primary, will be given the primary importance in the questionnaires. Analysis of questionnaires is carried out by aggregating the most occurring suggestions, that is I already stated. Next slide. This is the TSS questionnaire by NAC, which is available on the NAC website. The guidelines are given on the first page. That is, we are supposed to confirm that whether we are submitting this questionnaire at first time or not. We are supposed to click only, students are supposed to click only, then age, then the name of the college, then gender, and then the program, the degree, then subject area for the year pursuing currently. Then we will see. I would like to just consider, take some questions here instead of going through all 21 questions. The first question would be, how much of the syllabus was covered in the class? the students are supposed to opt any one option from 0 to 4, that is from below 30 to in between 85 to 100. The next question would be, how well did the teachers prepare for the classes? And then the 4 weightage is for thoroughly, 3 weightage for the satisfactorily, 2 for the poorly, 1 for the indifferently, and 0 for won't teach at all. Third question would be, how well were the teachers able to communicate? That is always, options are always effective, sometimes effective, just satisfactory, generally ineffective, very poor in communication, that carrying 0 mark, 0 weightage for it. The fourth question, the teacher's approach to teaching can best be described as, that is excellent, very good, good, fair and poor. These are the options. The fifth question would be fairness of the internal evaluation process by the teacher. Then again, there are 5 options, always fair, unusually fair, sometimes unfair, usual unfair and unfair. Then what was performance in assignment discussed with you? The seventh question, the institute takes active interest in promoting internship, students exchange, field visits, opportunities for students or not. The options regularly, often, sometimes, rarely or never. 8th questions would be the teaching and mentoring process in education in your institution facilitates you in cognitive, social and emotional growth. Then there are 5 options. Then the institution provides multiple opportunities to learn and grow. Students are supposed to opt any one out of 5 options, that strongly agree, neutral, disagree or strongly disagree. Then teacher inform you about your expected competencies, courses, course outcomes and program outcomes. Options every time, usually, occasionally, sometimes, rarely and never. 11 questions, your mentor does a necessary follow-up with assigned task to you. 12th question would be the teacher illustrate the concept through examples and application. Options every time, usually, occasionally, rarely, never. 13 questions would be the teacher identify your strengths and encourage you with providing right level of challenges, fully, reasonably, partially, slightly, unable to. These are the options. 14 questions would be, teachers are able to identify your weakness and help you to overcome them every time, usually, occasionally, rarely, never. These are the options. 15th questions would be, the institution makes effort to engage students in the monitoring review and continuous quality improvement of the teaching learning process. Strongly agree, neutral, disagree, strongly disagree. These would be the options. 16th questions would be, the institution or the teachers use student-centric method such as experimental learning, participative learning and problem-solving methodologies for enhancing learning experience. Options would be, to a great extent, moderate, somewhat, very little, not at all. 17 questions would be, teachers encourage you to participate in extracurricular activities. Strongly agree, neutral, disagree, strongly disagree. Give me questions. 18 questions would be, efforts are made by the institute teachers to inculcate soft skills, life skills and employability skills to make you ready for the world of work. To a great extent, moderate, somewhat, very little, not at all. These would be the options. What percent of teachers use ICT tools such as LCD projector, multimedia, etc. while teaching? The options would be above 90, 70 to 89, 50 to 69, 30 to 49 and below 29%. The second, that is 20th question, would be, the overall quality of teaching learning process in your institution is very good. Strongly agree, neutral, disagree, strongly decided these will be questions. These 20 questions will be having multiple, that is five choices. For the students, stop. The 21st question would be open-ended question, where it is asked to students to give three observations or suggestions to improve the overall teaching learning experience or the process of the college, that is institutions. And students are supposed to share their three observations or suggestions. Here, students should be very careful while putting their suggestions, because these suggestions should not be impractical. They should have to think about their locality and their limitations also. Now, problems in conducting AAAS. What problems, probable problems we may encounter while conducting a AAAS at our college level. Student satisfaction survey has been least practiced in the educational sector of India. It is recently, just NAC has introduced it in recently revised framework. There is a big questions on the validity of SSS due to decreased student attendance in the classroom. This is another obstacle. Computer illiteracy is one more obstacle, particularly in the rural or the tribal areas. Most of the students are not acquainted with the knowledge of use of ICT. Then the casual approach of student, this is also one of the obstacles. Then sometimes there are some impractical and some unrealistic expectations of students in open-end question, that is question number 21, which may create problem, because suppose college situated in a rural area and they are expecting the facilities like the A-grade institution or like the college located in a big city where all facilities can be provided. Some of the students are not acquainted with email IDs. Some of them are not having email IDs. The internet connectivity problem is also there, particularly in rural and tribal areas. In some cases, parents of rural areas are not willing to provide phone numbers and email IDs of their wards, especially of the rural, particularly of the girl students. These are the obstacles. Then what solutions are there, or what initiative we are supposed to take, or particularly by the IQC cell, or to acquaint the faculty and students with AAAS? The continuous conducting of AAAS every year at the end of the year, and we should have to conduct it in line of the NAC model, that is a questionnaire just now we went through. Then efforts should be made by the situation to increase the students. Then serious, we are supposed to take initiative to increase attendance of the students in the classes. Then we are supposed to include the detail what is required for us, that data we can use for it in admission forms, like the cell numbers and email IDs, etc. Next poster of AAAS should be uploaded on website, as well as should be displayed on the notice board, which I am going to share in another slide, the next slide, the next poster. Students should be oriented how to fill up the AAAS questionnaires. Students should be made aware of realities in education, so that their expectation should not be impractical, as far as particularly for the open-end question. And documentation of action taken on the basis of student feedback should be maintained by IQC. For example, regularization of remedial classes. It was one of the suggestions of the students made in the questionnaires. That's why we have regularized remedial classes. We have introduced the special lecture as per the demands and of the students. We have introduced the student seminar. We have included the use of ICT by teachers. These we can, we have to make documentation. We have introduced the departmental library to ensure better reading and facility students. Such types of documentation should be prepared and maintained by IQ cell after conducting SSS at local level, means quality level, every year. It is a regular activity. This is the analysis of the SSS conducted by my college when I was a coordinator of IPC. But our questionnaire we have prepared on a bit different level. Okay, just as the information I'm sharing it, and this is a graphical analysis of the same. Just I'm showing the slide for your ready reference. Then I'm sharing one more slide that how we can make aware to the regarding SSS. We can make this these types of the questionnaire which can be very easy to work through cell numbers also. This is one of the examples I'm sharing video. Look the questionnaires prepared by. We can use also Google Form for it, which is mobile friendly also. It is a sample one. There is no need to use emojis. I got it on the net. Very small one slide. Very wonderfully, it is made. This is the SSS awareness poster prepared by NAC. It is available on the NAC website. Every higher education institutions is supposed to upload in on your institutional website and also display this poster on the IQC notice board as well as college general notice board, so that students may be aware about this SSS and how to fill the questionnaires. I would like to give the example of the Netaji Subhash Open University. Just I have taken a screenshot instead of uploading the whole video, that such types of posters should be uploaded on the university website. Or such what are the software the questionnaires through Google Form or through any another software we are supposed to prepare. One more slide I would like to share with you. That is, this is the IGNU, the Indira Gandhi National Open University, having very robust and wonderful infrastructure. How the model is developed by them for the SS awareness among students. Look, it is very wonderful, very small video. It is having a few seconds. Go through it will help you.
Dear student of IGNU, greetings from IGNU. Hope you are healthy and safe. A survey is being conducted by the National Assessment or Accreditation Council, NAAC, which is the apex body for accreditation of all universities. Your participation in the Student Satisfaction Survey, SSS, is absolutely essential, as this is an important parameter for accreditation of IGNU. As a bona fide student of this university, IGNU US accreditation by NAAC will be of immense value to you in all your future endeavors. As a unit of good accreditation, grade points will be recognized by all employers and other stakeholders. SSS is being conducted directly by NAAC. NAAC is sending the survey questionnaire to the IGNU learners on their emails. You are requested to check your mailbox for any communication received from the survey and positively received on the 31st of July 2020 as the NAAC portal will close on the 31st of July 2020. The SSS consists of only 20 MCQs in which you simply have to select.
How wonderful it is. Very good. Very nicely prepared. If we prepare, the IQC cell prepare such types of things and send on students' cell numbers or their WhatsApps, they will be obviously, surely, confidently, I am sure about it, that they will be aware of it and that will help us for conducting SSS at institutional level also, and that will help us for the SSS being conducted by the NAC authorities at the time of accreditation. This is the appeal made by the director of the NAC, and I think that this letter is sent to all the vice chancellors and the principals by the NAC authorities, and the letter is available on its portal also, so that how important it is. I'm not interested to read the whole letter, that you are aware of. This is how the NAC is promoting the awareness of it. And my last slide is, I'm thankful for inviting me for this wonderful webinar. And
thank you, sir.
This is what I was supposed to talk on, the procedure and preparation for conducting SSR. On both front, at our college level and how it is being conducted by the NAC. This SSS brings a new dimension of taking the quality of education and the satisfaction of students therein. No matter how highly considered or reputed your university or college is, it is no greater than its students, because they are the one factor that makes the situation come alive. Therefore, during the preparation and implementation of your policies and strategies, the value of student satisfaction in higher education cannot be. I would like to share one more thing that I referred in my first or second slide regarding the serviceless model. In any business scenario, customers support service bears great satisfaction. Customer support service can be defined as a set of activities that assist in improving the level of customer satisfaction. But we have to be very careful with comparing education to the business model, because these are social institutions, not business selling commodities to consumers. Our mission should be to advance the human condition. Our measures of success as educator is changing lives and creating opportunities and making our democracy stronger. Our students are the end users of what we do, and we should carefully consider their experience and how colleges and universities are working for them. Colleges and universities absolutely need to treat their students like top prioritized stakeholders. The higher education institution must think to provide the top-notch customer service the parents and students expect from most of other industries. Students are product of higher education, shaped and modeled for the benefit of future employers. We find students are passive in their consumption of educational services. Hence, it is our duty to make them active, as the future success of the colleges will increasingly be determined by how they identify and satisfy their stakeholders, their students. And this may be the intention of NAC behind introducing this type of student satisfaction survey in their revised AA framework. And infusing customer satisfaction service principle into academia is really a welcome step, according to me. Like the servicial model, which is accepted globally, which is a method to capture the and measure the service quality experienced by the customers. TSSS will help to understand and measure the actual quality of teaching learning process and take measures to improve it. Quality of education with the emphasis on the priority of development of an educational institution as the system that meets needs and satisfaction of its customer, that is most important stakeholder, customer may not be the proper word for it, is very important. Hence, NAC has introduced it, and now it is our turn to implement the same. I wish all the best to your college and the all the institutions and its assessment and accreditation process by the NAC. Please conduct TSSS every year by all fair means only with the model developed by the NAC of the 21 questionnaires. I would be very happy to interact with the participants and address their queries, if any, on TSSS. Thanks, Dr. Sanju Jadhav and whole organizing team for inviting me. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your illustrative guidance about the student satisfaction survey. Once again, thank you for your sharing of expertise with us. Now, I would request all the participants to make this session more interactive, because now the time is for discussion. If there are any doubts, participants can ask about it.
Dr. Gajekar.
Yes. Good afternoon, sir. Your session was quite informative and it was quite useful for all of us.
Thank you.
As IQAC coordinator, even all the members, because your PPT and your questionnaire, you are very properly organized. By the way, this is not a question actually personally appealed to me, but as the question paper has been framed by uses, in NAC, that you are already displayed. And even all of us know the questionnaires that is displayed. But could you suggest that some questions are framed particularly for keeping in a view of the urban students? A few questions which are not able to solve by the rural area students. Could you explain that? Is there any provision that the rural areas can justify for that and give the proper answers to the questions? Absolutely, there is no segregation between the rural and urban as per the guideline of NAC, as you explained earlier. But being a rural area teacher, I have some questions that most of the students are not able to give the reply. And as per the guideline, there should be a proper reply. At least 10, more than 10% should give the reply for the mail, for maybe a telephone conversation. But this question is very serious in a rural area. Could you suggest some ideas that how we are able to give a fast reply?
Okay, Dr. Gajekar.
Rural students only.
Yeah,
urban students are quite computer savvy. Huh? Yes.
Yeah. There
so,
is provision.
This is a kind of kind of input that you would like to give for
there is provision. It is a mandatory to follow that questionnaire. Okay, these all the 20+1, that is 20 MCQ and one open end questions. There is no any alternative. What we can do is that we are supposed to orient students, as I have given the example of IGNU. Okay, and we have to encourage them to participate, and that they should not reply to the answer which will affect on institutions, estimation of institutions overall impression. Particularly, we should have to be careful on only one question, that is the 21st questions, because all other questions I think that no students will give the negative remark that no teachers are attending class, etc. Okay, and these students, I think that it will not affect to the rural students, because very, very meticulously these 20 questions are prepared. Okay, no questions is affecting that that will down the impression of the situations being the locality as a rural one. What I think so. Only we have to take care of the 21st question, and it is our duty to orient students that it is our institutions. We have to consider our limitations. Those facilities of the internet facilities we can't provide in the tribal area. Okay, those types of the high end facilities we can't provide college located geographically in the tribal and rural areas. These and students will also, I think that obviously take care of it. There is only remedy. We can't change question. There is no any provision made. Only the proper orientations that, and students are always positive. Okay, students and the parents, all people, all our stakeholders are always positive, and they are also having awareness about our limitations. Okay, and even the NAC peer team also consider it that in which locality college is working or imparting education. That's why it won't create problem, what I think so. Unmute, please. Unmute yourself, please.
Okay. Right, right. Thank you, sir. It was good that we can find out some solutions and try to gather the students
proper orientation, feedback. Only one remedy there is, what I think so.
Pre-orientation is important as per your discussion. If we pre-orient the students, that the students will get proper answers and feedback to the SSS.
I would like to give one example. When I was steering the NAC peer team visit for the second cycle as a coordinator of NAC steering committee, in the interaction with the students, current students, one girl raised her hand and said that she want ladies NCC unit. Okay, and in fact, our NCC unit has no provision of the female enrollment because they're required of the female trainer, etc. And the NAC peer team has mentioned in their report that ladies NCC unit should be started. But at the central government level, only once few years back, they made a provision to take a few percentages of the ladies, girls management. And there is a difficulty to, though you pursue up to the higher authorities, it is very difficult to get it sanctioned, and because due to the ladies training trainers and the other all the limitations, okay, as they are the girls. And though we tried our level best, our authorities, institutional authorities tried their best, it is very difficult. So students should be aware that such types of suggestions they should not make. Okay, this is the remedy we have. Okay. Hi, yes. So another question. Unmute, sir, yourself, please. Somebody, Raj Rajnikant Gaikwad ji, unmute and ask you, please, sir. I am unable to hear you.
Yes. Any more questions? If there are no more questions, I think it is time to reach to the concluding part of this second session. And therefore, may I now request my colleague, Professor R.D. Gaikwad, sir, to propose a vote of thanks to the second session of the webinar. Rajnikant Gaikwad.
Thank you, sir. Am I audible?
Yes, you are audible, sir.
Thank you, sir. Good afternoon, everybody. Greetings to all of you who are attending this webinar. I am Assistant Professor Rajnikant Gaikwad, Head Department of Computer Science, and also the Criterion in Charge number 7. I am in my sense of gratitude to the organizers of this webinar who invited me to propose vote of thanks. Honorable Chief Guest, Mr. Vinay K.Y., Honorable Dr. Arvind Navle, sir, Chairman of our Institute, Honorable Satyapati, Secretary of our College, Professor Jayantrao Ghorpade sir, Principal of our college, Professor Jawahar Chaudhary sir, Vice Principal Dr. Salve sir, Kadam Madam, Jagtap Madam, IQC Coordinator Dr. Sanju Jadhav sir, and most valued and worthy participants. Now I am here to extend my generous thanks to the entire participants and each and everyone who direct and indirect part of this webinar. We have been fortunate to have all the renowned attendees from academic area. I express my hearty thanks to all the resource person, Professor Vinay K.Y. and Dr. Arvind Nawle sir, who spent their precious time among us during this webinar. Vinay sir shared very valuable information about criterion-wise documentation of qualitative matrices. It will be definitely beneficial to all of us to maintain the documents very effectively. Dr. Arvind Nawle sir also addressed very important and useful information about SSS, that is Student Satisfaction Survey. He highlighted that the active participation of students in survey will not only empower the students, but also help institutions in continuous quality improvement through student engagement. No event can be successful without the provision of vast network of people. I express my gratitude towards every participant who is participated in this webinar from all over different colleges. Thanks for attending this webinar. I want to thank the chairman of our college, Honorable Satish Bhaiya Kakde Deshmukh, secretary of our college, Honorable Jayantrao Ghorpade sir, joint secretary, Honorable Satish Lakde sir, our principal, Professor Jawahar Chaudhary sir, and the organizer of this webinar, IQC coordinator and a very dynamic person, Dr. Sanju Jadhav. Thankful to the anchor of this webinar, my friend, Professor Santosh Chalke sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Oh, I also want to thank all my colleagues, teachers and administrative staff of our college for their support and cooperation in the organization of this webinar. Last but not the least, I want to thank all the criterion in charge, Dr. Devidas Vaidande sir, Dr. Srikant Ghadge sir, Professor Santosh Shelke, Professor Ravikiran More, Professor Narayan Rajubar, and